Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. Throughout human history, people have been fascinated with the night sky, plotting the positions of the stars, gazing at them through telescopes, and playing a massive scale version of Connect the Dots. And luckily for curious astronomers, there are lots of stars out there. In the Milky Way galaxy alone, there's estimated to be between 100 and 400 billion stars. And in the entire observable universe, there's estimated to be around 200 billion galaxies. So, yeah, there's a bunch of things out there, and because of that, it's probably a good thing that you know more about them. And to start, let's make our way over to a nebula in the constellation Orion and check out HOPS 383, the humble beginnings of a new star. This is known as a protostar, where sections of clouds of gas in space have collapsed under their own gravity. This causes the center to become hotter and denser, and for it to radiate energy away, collapsing it further. Until eventually, after millions and millions of years, when the star gets hot enough where its core temperature is above 10 million Kelvin, it becomes a main sequence star.
They grow up so slow.
And also, welcome to the adult world, young friend. It's all downhill from here. This is the stage of a star's life where nuclear fusion occurs, turning hydrogen into helium in its core. Not only does this produce the light you see coming from a star, but it also results in hydrostatic equilibrium, where the inward force of gravity is balanced out by outward gas and radiation pressure. And if you're looking for an example of one of these stars, you need look no further than the light of your life, the sun. In fact, a lot of stars in the universe are in this stage of their lives, and they vary widely. I mean, just take a look at the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram. This awesome tool conveniently tells you information about a star's temperature, luminosity, color, and more. And the main sequence stars span from the upper left, showing the hot, luminous stars, to the bottom right, showing the cool, faint stars. Oh, and see those letters down at the bottom? That's a classification scheme created by Annie Jump Cannon in the early 1900s based on stellar spectra. Hotter stars are O stars, and cooler stars are M stars. And as stars age and their characteristics change, their position on the HR diagram will change as well. Towards the end of a star's life, it will run out of hydrogen in its core and leave the main sequence state. For a star like the Sun, it will eventually turn into a red giant that may or may not completely destroy the Earth. Not cool, Sun. From here, eventually, any nuclear fusion will completely stop, and the star will collapse inward and become a tiny and incredibly dense white dwarf. Of course, that's not the only way a star can end its life. The others may die in a Type 2 supernova, producing dense neutron stars, and others may even form stellar black holes. Man, stars sure do like to make dramatic exits, huh? So I hope this will make you look at the night sky a little differently. And if you're curious to know how much money space is actually worth, well, then you should check out this video. The total value of the moon's resources has been estimated at between $150 and $500 quadrillion dollars. Yup. Quadrillion. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.